Okay, so we'll go ahead and get our meditation posture. And we're going to do two different controlled breathing exercises. In Buddhist meditation, we're almost always doing mindfulness, meaning like, don't solve any of your problems. If you're agitated, be agitated. But sometimes these problems can actually be solved kind of quickly. So what we're going to do first is this 11-second breathing. So there's a bunch of sources that seem to agree that the optimal breath takes 11 seconds for both the in-breath and the out-breath. That's 5.5 seconds per breath. So in just a second here, I'll set a timer, and I won't announce every 5.5 seconds for the whole time. But I'll do it just for the beginning so you can get the rhythm. We want to breathe through the nose, both in and out, as long as your nose is open enough. So we actually, for the whole time, you can try to keep your mouth closed. And we want to breathe slowly and quietly. Okay, so we'll start with an in-breath here. And out. In. Out. In. Out. In. And so we'll keep the breath going at approximately that rhythm. I want to keep the air slow and steady so you're not gulping for air. Of course, this doubles as a breath concentration, as a shamatha anapana practice. But you might find it easier. The fact that we're controlling the breath gives us something to do, makes it easier to focus on usually. And it's fine if you want to count in your head. It's 5.5 seconds, so counting to either 5 or 6 should work nicely. And as you get your breath slow like this, it can get pretty hard to actually feel the breath of the nose. So don't worry about that too much. And find a focus on the control of the breath, particularly if you can't feel the sensations. And sometimes it's certainly working for me. This gets really relaxing. So, our goal is to be relaxed and stay awake. So, if you feel like sleep is a risk, you can make your posture straighter or open your eyes. Your heart rate actually entrains to your breathing rate. So, by cultivating this slow breath, you actually slow down your heart, which is maybe about the same as saying you become more relaxed. And if you get that desire, like you want to gasp for air, of course it's okay if you forget and you do, but I would actually try not to. It's not like we're holding our breath or anything. So we'll keep this pace for a few more minutes. I'll just count out the seconds one more time. So that's starting here. 5.5. And again. And as I wind up saying almost every class, because we're in such a loud urban area, I always say thank you to the outside sounds. The internal distractions can be so hard to let go of. Our neighbor is walking upstairs and the music on the street. I use it like a mindfulness bell. It's very easy to let go of it. Obviously, it has nothing to do with me. So we'll change up the rhythm. This next one, I mean, it's not hard, but it's a little harder because you got to breathe slower. And so what we're going to do is we're going to breathe in for about 4 seconds and then out for about 8. So we'll let all the air out. It'll come in. 1, 2, 3, 4, and out. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. Gotta really like savor the exhale. And you'll get more air out than you do in normal breaths this way. It of course defeats the point to stress over how you're breathing. So if holding the out breath till 8 is hard, hold it less. Or sorry, not holding it. The breath should be circular here, so not long pauses between, but continuing it to 8. And for the last part, if you're feeling like the 4-8 is pretty easy, see if you can do 6-12, if you can slow it down even more. This is getting into the realm where you might get euphoric or you might get dizzy. Of course, if it's too slow, speed it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And again, if you're trying the 6-12, that's pretty slow. So don't power through. If you're getting a headache, just take your breath faster.